Lake Township High School. Welcome to today's morning announcements. I am so excited to be here today because we have a special guest, our class of 2020 valedictorian, Miss Samantha Nafee. What's up, Sam? How are we doing today?
I'm doing good. How about you?
Good, good. It's great to see you. Congratulations. You know, the class, being the class valedictorian is just a tremendous accomplishment. I'm so proud of you. I've known you for longer than your time at the high school, but you know, the work ethic and the dedication and commitment to your studies that it took to get to this moment for you. I know how much you sacrificed and what you needed to do to get here. And it just means so much to us to have you represent Pequannock Township High School. So congratulations. And I look forward to just talking with you for a little while about what it means to be class valedictorian. So
thank you.
Honored to be here with you today. So Sam, how does it feel to be class valedictorian? What does it mean to you?
I have been working towards being the valedictorian for probably longer than even high school and middle school. It was something I knew that I wanted. So just the fact that I was able to push myself and really challenge myself to get where I am today is something that's kind of beyond my comprehension even. But I was genuinely so shocked and excited and still kind of like on cloud nine about the whole thing. But yeah, I mean, I worked for it. I think I deserve it. And I'm just really happy to have the title.
Oh, it's awesome. You know, I remember when we came to your house and, you know, told you and you jumped up into your dad's arms and you were like, we did it. We did it. And and that just speaks to, it wasn't just about you. You make learning contagious for everyone. You know, and everybody wanted to see you be successful. And, you know, it was a true, it was a team effort. Cause I know you had a lot of support at home, but you know, there were times that I know you had to make sacrifices, you know, and we talked about this at the valedictorian salutatorian dinner we had, you know, and, you know, just the hard work pays off, right? When you put all that time and effort into it.
Yeah.
that's awesome. You know, and obviously being the valedictorian, you had to excel in your classes. What was one of your favorite classes and why?
Probably one of my favorite classes, actually was my financial literacy class that I was one of the only seniors in the room. I took it this past year with Mr. Brady. I never had Mr. Brady before because I had never really taken a business class at the school. But for some reason, all the stars aligned and I had him as my teacher, and it made having that last period at the end of the day just made something to look forward to for me. And I could listen to Mr. Brady talk for hours, so that might have been part of it too. But yeah, I mean, I did learn a lot of practical stuff in that class, but also just the feeling of being there and knowing that, yeah, I might have been in a room full of freshmen, but that I was still like a part of like this community and that I wasn't belittled or anything by the fact that like I was taking a class with all underclassmen, if that kind of makes sense. But it was honestly one of my favorite experiences this year.
That's awesome. And I'm sure Mr. Brady would love to hear that. You know, the financial literacy course is, you talked about the practical skills. That's a critical course for you as you go and move on, you know, and I know you have big dreams. Those some of those skills you're going to need because, you know, I use them every day. And so that when you take a class where you can, you know, you can see the relevance to it, it really is important. And so thank you for sharing that with us. That's great to hear. You know, when you think about in totality your experience at Pequannock Township High School, what are you going to remember the most about your time here?
Oh, gosh. Probably just things that happened outside of school, but because of school. I made so many, like, different relationships in a lot of different classes that I took. And just being able to carry those kind of, like, friendships outside of the classroom and being able to hang out with people that I never really saw myself being super close with at the onset of the year. And then by the end of like a school year, having like made best friends out of some of my classes and experiences. But yeah, I would definitely say just the people that I've met and been able to get close with because of my experiences at the school.
And hold on to those friendships, because when you get to be my age, you know, those friendships really do mean things. And you know, now we connect on Facebook, and I don't know what the social media will be when you're older, but you know, it's nice to connect with them and share experiences with them and reminisce a little bit. And so that's tremendous. You know, you talked about your experience in the financial literacy course and being a senior in a class with freshmen. You know, what piece of advice would you give for the underclassmen? What would you tell them?
This is actually something that Mr. Portis had said at the valedictorian salutatorian dinner Zoom that we had. And because I had said something about how I wish that I could have maybe been more social and gone to more school events after school and everything, instead of just focusing so much on my studies. And he said that if you enjoy it, then there's no real need to apologize for it or have the want to do anything else. And I call me crazy, but I genuinely enjoyed doing my schoolwork most times. So just to hear that you don't always have to like enjoy going out and having outings, and you can enjoy doing your homework and staying home and just being like with your family, and it's not something that you have to regret. So I would just say, do what you like, even if a lot of people might think you're crazy for enjoying it.
That is a tremendous piece of advice. You know, that's something that, you know, it's interesting that you picked up on that because at the dinner, because I picked up on that too. You know, I enjoy working. It's just, you know, I do. And I'm not shy about it. I'm happy to say that I enjoy working. It makes me feel good, you know? And, so it's a great piece of advice, you know, and I appreciate that, Sam. You know, in a couple of days, you're going to be graduating from Pequannock Township High School. You know, what are your future plans? What do you want to go and do?
So I'm going to Boston University. I was actually admitted into their Boston to London program. So I start in January, start spring semester, and then I have a summer semester in London for my freshman year. And then I go on to the rest of school. And I will be double majoring in English and philosophy, and then hopefully going to law school afterwards. So yeah.
Good for you. Those are big dreams, big plans. And you know, I have no doubt that you are going to accomplish anything that you set your mind to. You know, watching what you've done over this time, you know, just phenomenal. And it sounds like the police are coming for you.
Yeah, I know.
Sirens are going past your house. I think that you know, the work that you've done here at the high school has just been tremendous. And like I said in the beginning, you have made us so proud. And you know, don't forget about us when you go on and be successful. You know, because I know I'll still be here. So stop by and say hello. But I'm so glad that we had this opportunity to talk a little bit and share your story, because it's just a tremendous one. So continue to write new chapters in your story, Sam, as you go on into your career. And we wish you the best of luck. So everybody, Samantha Nafee, our class valedictorian. Congratulations, Sam.
Thank you.
Have a great day, everybody. Hey, Panthers, rise and shine. Happy Tuesday. We got another beautiful day outside, and it's really starting to feel like summer. Hey, a big shout out to Sam Nafee, our class of 2020 valedictorian. Just amazing to hear her story all the time, and just so proud of who she represents and the work that she did to get here. And it reminds me of a quote from Colin Powell that says, "A dream doesn't become reality through magic. It takes sweat, determination, and hard work." You know, Sam had a dream to be valedictorian. She worked at it, she sacrificed, and she did it. And that's all we want in life, right? To set a goal, accomplish it, and keep moving forward. So best of luck to you, Sam, and thank you for representing Pequannock Township High School. Just one announcement today, really, and that's we're going to continue our locker cleanout, so make sure you're following the schedule. And if you miss your day, it's okay. Just come on any of the other days and times, and we'll get things taken care of. Remember to bring your materials with you in a bag labeled with your name on it, and we'll have everybody there to help you out. We're going to continue our graduation recording today. And don't forget, this Friday, seniors, you got prom on the go. So we're really looking forward to that event as well. You know, Panthers, we're coming down to the wire. We don't have a lot of announcements left, but it is important to stay on top of your schoolwork. So thank you for all your efforts. Stay hungry, stay hydrated, keep those claws sharp, and let's make Tuesday a great one. Take care, Panthers.